have myalgic encephalomyelitis, also known as chronic fatigue syndrome. It's a debilitating illness, much like an advanced case of mono, that remains in your system for years. I used to be a very active child, horses, soccer, and whatnot. Then in 2003, I caught a flu-like illness, and for the next 3 years, my bed and doctors were all I saw, because this flu never went away. And in 2005, I was finally diagnosed with chronic fatigue syndrome from Laura Black, a specialist in Charlotte, North Carolina. Dr. Black works alongside Dr. Charles Lapp at the Hunter Hopkins Center for Chronic Fatigue Patients.
So chronic fatigue syndrome is a syndrome. A syndrome is a constellation of symptoms that may or may not be seem to be associated with one another. So when you have a group of symptoms that affect or impair daily functioning, we call it a syndrome. And as our little moniker, the pain, the brain, the energy drain, and oh, how I wish I could sleep again, refers to the pain, obviously, the brain referring to the cognitive dysfunction, the energy drain referring to the fatigue, the debilitating fatigue, and the sleep dysfunction, how I can sleep again. Right, those are the main, you know, the four primary symptoms. Obviously, chronic fatigue syndrome does not really do the syndrome justice. Okay.
I was so happy to have a diagnosis, to know that there were people out there just like me, suffering the same symptoms and the same problems that I was.
My days are driven by what is my pain level. Some days it's better than others, but it's kind of an hour-by-hour assessment.
Brain just too far out of it to even register what's going on.
What they call post-exertional malaise, which is I can do things, but the price is I fall apart later.
Not being able to put things together, not being able to remember words, not being able to spell correctly.
The body temperature dysregulation, so I don't have a set body temperature. I can go from 97 to 100 in a day, and it's, boy, that doesn't feel very good.
Remember to do that. It's
okay, but if I do forget, just...
Tara Ames has been living with chronic fatigue syndrome for 4 years now. She currently resides in Northern Virginia with her husband and miniature dachshund.
And then about a month later is when I started having these, I don't even know how you call these, episodes in the middle of the night. And it was always in the middle of the night, nobody knows why, still to this day. But starting that fall of 07, going all the way, it took about a year, I think, to get rid of it. Almost a year. I'd wake up in the middle of the night. I'd go to bed feeling fine. And I'd wake up in the middle of the night, and I'd be so nauseous and so dizzy. And I'd be, like, covered in sweat, night sweats, headache, like, such dry mouth, such dry... My eyes were dry, like, every night. I could, like, barely peel them open in the morning. They hurt so bad. I was so such dry throat. And then I'd have to go... All of a sudden, I'd stand up and have to, like, run to the bathroom to throw up. And I would, like, alternately throw up and go to the bathroom over and over. But that was horrible, the nauseousness. And I'd have these pains in my stomach where it felt like somebody was, like, going like this with everything in my stomach. And that was bad. But the worst part was the dizziness and the nausea were so bad that I couldn't sit still. I couldn't lay down. I couldn't stand. I couldn't do anything. And when I'd stand up, I'd get so dizzy and be off-center that I'd, like, walk straight into the wall. Or I'd walk into the door frame, you know, or whatever, because I was, like, trying to go to the bathroom and I couldn't get my balance. And it would take all night, literally all night for me to, and I'd get everything out of my system. And, you know, sometimes there's no way I could feel better. And
I often get a blank stare when I tell people about chronic fatigue syndrome. It's hard to know how to explain this.
You say you have a metabolic dysfunction. You say, well, what does that mean? You say that my body doesn't produce the energy that's necessary to metabolize air, water, oxygen, food, in order to have the ability to do the daily things that I need to do.
Yes, I have gotten that, you don't look sick. And if you see me, my colleagues that see me in the office, you know, other than the days that they saw me laid out on the floor, would have no idea, you know, oh, I'm actually nauseous all day, you know, I have a terrible headache right now. Looks definitely can be deceiving.
But then, you know, like you said, you look fine. When I would do these conference calls for work, I'd do nothing all morning because I knew I'd be talking. And then I'd talk and, like, I sound fine now. And they would literally say to me, wow, you sound fine. You can't even tell you're sick. Well, you seem really upbeat. Are you better now? Or, like, some people would be like, oh, everybody that was on the conference call with you last week was saying how great you sounded. And, like, a couple times I'd meet them for lunch, and I'd be like, you look great. And I'd be like, I haven't done anything in 3 days. I'm going to have to take a two-hour nap after this. And I'm not going to be able to do anything for 2 more days. Like, the reason I look so good is because I can plan my life for a short, not always, but I can sometimes plan my life so that for a short snippet of time, I'm normal or okay. But you don't see what goes into that and, like, the aftermath. My poor husband and family are the people that see the aftermath of me, like, on the floor, like, yeah, move, you know? And can you make me dinner? Can you do this? Can you take the dog out? Can you clean the house? Can, you know?
Yeah.
And it's lonely. Like, I really don't feel like anybody understands what it's like.
I would say family members and my sister, my mother, you know, were the two biggest support systems for me. You know, my church, but really just my close family, because they're the only ones that saw it every day and they lived it with me every day. So they believe me. They, you know, I would say my dad, who doesn't live with me and who, you know, my parents were divorced at 13, doesn't understand because he didn't see it every day. And he really doesn't know about this illness. And until this year, I mean, I've had this illness almost 23 years, until this past year, did he really understand when he came to see me and that I couldn't move and no, I can't go out to lunch with you and Cheryl, I'm sorry. You know, it's just, they didn't realize that I couldn't physically get up and put on makeup or drive or do anything until they came and saw me. And then they kind of got it. And because I was so good at hiding that from people. I'm so good at putting on makeup and dressing up and being on, and people, they don't see the chronic fatigue, the illness, a lot.
It's been 7 years since I first got sick, and with every year I look back and realize I'm getting better. I'm now in a photography program at my local community college. I spent the summer working on 2 films, one at a film school. I have a social life again, with friends that try to understand and support me. But I still have chronic fatigue syndrome. And I probably always will. But I'm determined to live a normal life. There just might have to be a few accommodations. And I have hope for the future of CFS. We will discover the cause and help for those who are suffering.
I remain positive and upbeat that we're going to continue to fight, and we are going to win. But we don't have the strength, we don't have the energy to win, so we have to rely on our loved ones.
There's so many wars we fight. There's so many things we're not. But with what we have, I promise you that we're marching on, we're marching on, we're
for
marching
the plans
on.
We've made, there isn't a flag I'd wave. Don't care if we bend, I seek us to swim.